Hello and welcome. In this video, you are going to learn the task tracking philosophy of Redmine and how to configure the workflow according to your needs. This is the task detail page, where we are going to focus on three key attributes: assignee, tracker, and status. We start with the tracker. Trackers can be configured in administration. Go to More, Administration, Trackers. Here you can see the list of all trackers, such as Task, Help Desk Ticket, Feature Development, and so on. To access more settings, click on the tracker name. Trackers can be assigned to projects. For example, when you do not need this tracker in Help Desk projects, you can remove it. All the other trackers' settings are explained in a different video. Now let's move to the statuses. One of the most important features of status is whether it closes the task or not. You can see that most of the statuses do not have the parameter task closed set. This means that when a task has one of these statuses, it is still open. When a task has the done or canceled status, it is considered closed. The task closed parameter is reflected throughout the whole application. Assignee is a user included in the project as a team member. Project members are listed and configurable in the project settings. Here you can see a list of the project members and their roles. John has the developer role. When you need to add a project member, click New Member, choose a member or group, define the role for the project, and click Add. To configure roles, go to the administration. Here you can define new roles and assign permissions to them. It is very important to configure the workflow settings for every role. The task assignee is not the only user who works with tasks, and his role doesn't define permissions for other users. There are also managers and coworkers. Each of them may have other role set and should have other permissions for fields and status changes. To conclude, the role of the user is the key attribute in terms of permissions to manage tasks. Let's go back to the task detail. The tracker is feature development, and the status is new. Now we move to the administration, workflow, and check how all this is interconnected. Here you can define the behavior and permissions for each role and each tracker. Choose Role and Tracker. Click the Edit button to modify the workflow settings. The task we were looking at has new status. That means new is the status, and we need to set whether the role developer can move the task to another status. When the status is new, user can move it to realization to start working and consult the task. This way you can define the workflow for any role and any tracker, meaning we can set which roles can close the task and which roles cannot. Let's go through the settings in more detail. The role developer cannot change the task status to the new. This means that when a user receives the task, he must start working on it. Also, he cannot put the task into the done or canceled statuses, so the user cannot close it. However, there are other possibilities. You can define that when the user is the author or assignee of the task, he can have additional permissions. For example, he can close the task. When a user is the author or assignee of the task, he can change the task status from anyone to done. It means that the author of the task with this workflow has additional permissions. When you create a new task status, it will not be assigned to any tracker or any role. You need to configure it in the workflow settings. We have saved the settings, and now let's have a look at it from the worker's perspective. When user updates the task, he sees only the task statuses allowed for user's role. In this case, these are realization and consultation. However, the status transitions are just one part of the workflow. Let's look at the task detail again. Here you can see other fields, such as start date, due date, author, estimated time, and so on. Workflow for these attributes can also be configured in the workflow settings according to the role and tracker. Let's look at the tracker's administration for feature development. Here you can see the standard fields visible on the tracker and the custom fields which you can manually create and assign to the tracker. To configure workflow in terms of the field's permissions, go to Workflow, Task Fields Permissions, or CRM Fields Permissions. Then choose Role and Tracker. Then you can choose whether the field is read-only or required. For example, if you want your users to always enter a due date, set it to Required. And do not forget that this setting applies to the new task status only. Every time a task is assigned to a user with the developer role, the due date will be required, and user cannot leave it blank. Do not forget to save the settings. This is how it looks like from the user's perspective. You are logged in as John, and when trying to update the task, you see that the due date is marked as required, and therefore is red. That means it must not be empty. When you try to save it with an empty due date, you will get an error message saying that the due date cannot be blank. This was the workflow philosophy of Easy Redmine. We hope it will help you manage your projects effectively. Thank you for watching, and good luck with your projects.